Nature is full of life force energy. This is qi. It fills up the space all around us, and in Qigong we say it moves between heaven and earth. Just like nature, our bodies are full of life force energy. In this course, what it's my hope is that you discover your qi for yourself. Discovering qi is not about knowing it in your head, but about experiencing it in your body. Let's begin by feeling qi as it flows through our own bodies. The first place to start is the hands. Take your palms in front of you and just vigorously rub them together. This will create a little blood flow. It'll activate the nervous system. That combination of blood flow, good circulation, and the activity of the nervous system is called qi. It's that combination of life force energy in our bodies, and we can feel it easily in our hands. Rub the palms together vigorously. Rub them together until you feel the palms getting warm. Take a deep breath. And then just relax. Bring your hands down to your sides. Notice how your palms feel. The goal of this program is to feel and experience the sensation of qi in your body. Once we experience the sensation, what it feels like, we become more resourceful in how to work with that energy. The sensation of qi is like electricity. It's that bioelectrical magnetic force that moves through the body and activates all the cells. Can you feel that? You feel buzzing, tingling, warm, radiant, a sensation in the palms of your hands. Try it again. Rub them together vigorously. Take a nice deep breath. And then just relax your hands down to your sides. When you feel and experience qi in your body, what you're doing is taking your awareness and your attention and turning it inward. Most of the time in life, our attention is going outward. We're focusing our mental energy externally to our body. In your qigong practice and the way to discover qi, you're going to reverse that. You're going to turn your attention inward, place it on the life force energy in your body, and allow it to grow. When your mind and your body start to interact and meet in that place, that qi starts to circulate in a much better way. Palms face up. Let's just shake here. Okay, we're gonna open the yin meridians of the arms so that we can feel the energy stronger in our hands. So your palms are face up and you're shaking. Meridians mean rivers of energy. In the Chinese medicine system, rivers of energy move through the body to circulate this life force energy in this qi. Acupuncture points flow along these meridians, along these rivers of energy. So we can stimulate those rivers of energy through movement, through stretching, and through flowing exercises. So do this vigorously. This movement is like you're fanning yourself, like you're really hot, fanning yourself and stimulating. So you want the wrist to go down and forward. Now as you're doing this, take a nice deep breath. Just let the wrist relax, let the arms open. And then again, bring your hands to your sides and you'll feel this activity, this buzzing, tingling energy going down through the wrists into your hands. You can even close your eyes. And again, just turn your attention inwardly, feel that life force energy. Anytime we turn our attention inwardly, in Qigong we think of that as meditation. Instead of energy going outward, we're reversing that, we're bringing it inward. Your Qigong practice is like a moving meditation. And when you bring that attention inwardly, it helps that life force energy circulate. Whenever we pay attention to our bodies, it's the beginning of a healing process. Let's do the reverse of that. We're going to place the hands, palms face down, and then shake this way. So here we're opening the meridian lines that flow along the outside of the arms to the back of the hands. And again, shake vigorously. The wrists are going to move up and all the way down. Completely relax the wrists. In Qigong, we want to work with the principle of relaxation, because as your body relaxes, energy circulates much more efficiently. When you relax, think of those meridian pathways, those rivers of energy opening up and flowing better. Shake vigorously, take a nice deep breath. And again, hands down to your sides, and you'll notice now a stronger sensation because both the front of the wrists and the back of the wrists are open. Close the eyes, notice how your hands feel. When this life force energy, when chi circulates in your body, it's like water moving in nature. When water moves, we say that that water is healthy, it has healthy life force. This is the water that we can drink. When water doesn't move, it gets stagnant, it pools and doesn't circulate. The same is true in your body. When chi circulates, your body's healthy. When it stops circulating, we say that that chi gets stagnant or stuck, and this leads to pain, problem, sickness, or even disease. The whole goal of this practice through various exercises is to get that life force energy to circulate and to increase that vitality, health, and wellness in your body. All right, now bring your hands here to your sides. We're going to do a flowing movement that'll help this chi to circulate inside of you. Flowing movements are like Tai Chi exercises. Qigong is said to be the mother of Tai Chi because it's older, it's more ancient, and it's the exercises that will get energy to circulate in your body. This particular movement is called Tai Chi opening. And here we're just bringing the arms up and down in a slow, relaxed, fluid way. As your arms float up, go ahead and inhale. And as your arms come down, exhale. Now, over thousands of years, Qigong masters discovered that by moving your body slowly, just like we're doing here, slowly with flow and relaxation, that life force energy increases. We say that it tonifies, it gets stronger in your body. So here, think of your spine like a wave in the ocean. It just flows. The current of energy flows up through the spine and out through the arms. And then it flows from the arms back down into the body. Synchronize your breath with your movement, inhaling up and exhaling down. Inhale, bring the arms up. Exhale, relax the arms down. Long, deep breathing, graceful, fluid movement, attention on the flow of life force energy in the body. All of these things help to increase chi, strengthen your life force energy. Okay, relax a little bit more. With each breath, relax a little deeper. And start to allow your mind just to sink into your body and experience chi in the present moment. When you're feeling energy, when you're feeling your body, your mind is in the present moment. It's not thinking about future or worrying about the past. In the present moment, this is where life force energy is. So the benefits of doing fluid flowing movements are many. One, to increase life force energy. But a second benefit is to connect to the present moment. So we establish our mind into relaxation, into calmness. Just a few more times. Go ahead and close your eyes. Notice the way your body moves through space. Bring your hands down. Arms down to your sides. You can bring your feet a little closer together. Close your eyes and notice how your body feels. See if you can just sense that chi, that life force energy in your own body. As you become aware of this energy, your body begins a healing process. Your body begins to find its own equilibrium and balance, and you discover not only your chi, but you discover truly who you are from the inside out. Chi is that fundamental substance that composes your whole entire being. It's the force that moves through your cells. It's the force that beats your heart. pumps through your nervous system and even gives rise to the activity of consciousness. Take one more deep breath. And as we go through this program, we'll be doing many exercises that'll help you to discover Qi for yourself. Enjoy. You might have had your first experience of what Qi felt like in your body. Discovering Qi is truly about experiencing energy for yourself. We say that the experience of energy leads to wisdom. It's different than just knowing something in your head or understanding an intellectual process of what Qi does for the body. To experience is to give your body wisdom and the power to make changes and shifts in your own internal energy. When we become resourceful in working with this energy, we can take ourselves from our own internal state of where we are right now into where we want to be in our energy and in our health and even in our lives. Qi is not only a power that works inside of you, but it works external as well. We have a relationship between our body, between nature, and between our environment. Think of Qi as electricity. If your TV set has no electricity, nothing works. The same is true of your body. When someone has an abundance of energy, they have abundance of vitality and health. So these next set of exercises are really going to be designed to increase the energy in your body. They're going to work on the lower body. They're going to work on your lower back, your legs, and your kidneys as a way to charge up the battery of the body and really get it to circulate inside you. Let's start with the first exercise. It's called knocking on the door of life. The door of life is a pressure point on the lower back. This point is called Ming Men, which means life gate. When we knock on the body, when we stimulate through percussion, it wakes up the dormant Qi in the body. The Qi that has a tendency to get sleepy or fatigued. We knock on it and it stimulates it, then we do movement to circulate it. This will be an excellent exercise to really invigorate your health and vitality. The door of life is a point right here. We're going to be knocking across this point. So when the arms knock across the lower body, it'll help to stimulate the energy in this area called the belt channel. The belt channel is the area and the energy that moves across the abdomen into the lower back. Bend your knees, relax your arms, and just start turning from your hips and your waist. Just do a little turning motion from your hips and your waist. One of the practices of Qigong is to relax the rest of the body and move from your center. Your center is this area here, your hips, your waist, and your lower abdomen. In Qigong, this is called Dan Tian, which means lower reservoir. Turn from your hips and your waist. Relax your arms and then let the arms knock lightly across your lower abdomen and across your lower back. Turn a little bit from your hips and your waist. So you want your spine to be moving. This area stays relaxed, the arm stimulating those pressure points. Good, take a nice deep breath. Your knees are bent as a way to stay grounded and as a way to generate the energy into your spine. This is one of the exercises that is called a spinal cord enlivening exercise. Brings healthy vitality into the back, into the nervous system. Again, take a nice deep breath, and then just turn gently and look over your shoulder. So we bring that flexibility and flow not only into the low back, but all the way up through your upper back. And then do this exercise a little more vigorously, just knock a little stronger. This exercise will increase and wake up the energy of the body. It's a nice exercise actually to do in the morning because it stimulates the kidneys and the adrenal glands. When you drink coffee, coffee stimulates the adrenal glands and naturally wakes up the body. This exercise will do it from the inside out. So you can think of this exercise as your Qigong morning cup of coffee. Wakes up that vital energy. Take one more deep breath. Bring your hands down to your sides now. Feel that energy moving from the inside out. After knocking on the door of life, the energy moves up the spine, brings chi into your nervous system, comes down the arms into your hands. Take a deep breath and just notice. Notice the sensations in your body. Good. So from here, let's do a chi massage at the lower back. It'll stimulate the kidneys, the low back, and vital pressure points to tonify the body's internal energy. We're going to be tapping on the low back area. When you knock on the kidney area on the low back, use this part of your hand. And then when you come down to the tailbone area, you can use your knuckles. So it looks like this. So go up and down the lower back area. Stimulate the kidneys. The kidneys are thought of as the internal batteries of the body. They're the deepest energy of the body. So when you knock and tap on this area, it stimulates and increases the vital energy through not only the kidneys, but through all the other organ systems as well. Now, just massage up and down the kidney area. Do it vigorously, warm up the kidneys. We say that when you energize the kidneys, it's good for not only vitality, but it's also good for longevity. So warm up your kidneys, take a nice deep breath, and then relax, hands down to the sides, and begin a little shaking movement. So just relax your wrists, your elbows, and your shoulders. Shaking is a good way to wake up that dormant energy, just like knocking on the door of life for that chi massage. But it does something else. It helps to clear stress and tension out of the body. You see athletes do this before events. It transforms nervous energy into something that's usable, into our potential. So we're shaking, and then bounce into your heels. Just sort of scan your body. Anywhere you're holding tension or stress or tightness, see if you can shake into that area. So relax your neck and shoulders. Relax kind of between the shoulder blades and down the spine. Relax your lower back. And then take a nice deep breath in through the nose. Long exhale out through the mouth. Inhale in through the nose. And exhale with a long sigh. That sigh, that exhale out through the mouth will relax the chest. It clears emotional energy. We say that this exercise, shaking, transforms stress. Transform stress into vitality. Again, inhale. Long sigh. You can't do this exercise and feel stress at the same time. This exercise will transform that stress and bring it back into just that pure energy in your body, into something that's usable for your health, vitality, and wellness. Keep going. You do this exercise for a minute or two and it really increases the energy in your body. You'll really feel it moving and circulating. We want to feel the energy. We want to feel it move in our bodies. Take one more deep breath. Shake out the wrists and the hands. And then slowly relax and notice how your body feels. Hands down to the sides. Close your eyes. And allow your mind just to turn inwardly and land in that field of energy that's inside your body. Turn your mind inward and experience chi from the inside out. Notice how your arms and hands feel. See if you can breathe a little energy from your arms up into your body, into your chest, through your internal organs, down your legs. Breathe a little energy up the spine, into the head, and get that chi to circulate. Remember, when chi circulates, it brings healthy vitality. We want chi to not settle in and become dormant or stagnant. That stagnation creates tightness. Circulation of energy creates vitality and health. Can you feel that? Deep breath, and relax. So Qigong exercises come in various forms. Some are stretching exercises, some are stimulating exercises like we're doing in this session, and other exercises are flowing. Each exercise is a different way to move energy inside your body. When we move energy in different ways, this creates overall wellness and equilibrium and balance. This next one is called the fountain. It's a flowing movement that brings energy upward through the body and around. So the back of your hands come towards each other. You're hinging forward a little bit at the waist and then rising up and out. It's a flowing movement. Flowing movements are metaphorical. They move your body like water. Your body is more than 70% water, so we're tapping into that principle and getting energy to circulate. Water moves with intrinsic strength, meaning that water is very fluid. It has a principle of relaxation, but also at the same time, it's very powerful. So move your body with internal power and flow. Exhale the arms down, and inhale, bring the arms up. Exhale, and inhale. Remember, flowing movements, it was discovered that this increases the energy in your body. One of the reasons is, as your body slows down, so does your mind. Your mental activity starts to become more calm and more relaxed. So here, as you're slowing your body down, notice that your mind starts to slow down, and we cultivate that inner tranquility and peace. From a state of deep relaxation, energy starts to increase, starts to circulate. Exhale, bring a wave-like quality up through the spine and then out through the arms. Bring a wave-like quality, let it rise up through the body and then go out through the arms. So if I turn to the side, the movement of the spine is like this. So we bring the arms up and down. A wave-like quality rises up through the back, out through the arms. You can use the ocean as a metaphor on how to move the body with flow and internal power. In Qigong, martial artists use these exercises, these slow, fluid exercises, to cultivate energy. After a while, what they discovered was that these fluid exercises, not only were they good for cultivating energy, but they gave the body abundant health. Close the eyes, relax, breathe in flow, exhale out tension. Train your body to move with relaxation rather than force in your muscles. Move with flow, lightness, and effortless power. Bring your hands down to your sides and relax. Again, notice how your body feels. It feels a little bit different than those stimulating exercises, than the shaking exercise. It's a little bit more calm, deeper energy circulating. Those flowing movements are called moving meditations because they get the mind and the body to harmonize. Take one more deep breath. The nice thing about this Qigong practice that it just starts to seep into every aspect of your life. So notice as you go through your day today, if you can bring some of this calm, vital energy, this presence, and this stability into the rest of your day. Welcome to session 3. By now you should have a sense of what qi feels like in your body. Qi feels good. It feels good to cultivate this life force energy. You should notice that as you cultivate and expand your own energy, that you feel healthier. You feel more alive. You feel more excited about your life. The goal isn't just to do the Qigong exercises and have it benefit just your practice. It actually should benefit your whole entire life. So let's progress with our practice. This session is going to work a little bit more on the upper body. It's going to help to clear emotional stress and tension, open and clear tension that gets stored in the muscles, like in the neck and shoulders, and really get this chi to circulate through the arms and all the way down to the hands. Chi means life force energy, like we described before. Originally, chi meant was a character in Chinese that meant vapor rising off of water or off of rice. So this idea of chi means that chi is invisible. It's like the wind. It moves, but you can't see it. You can feel and experience chi, but we can't perceive it just with our senses. There's more to chi than meets the eye. So when we're feeling chi, the whole goal is to experience what chi is inside your body. They describe chi a little bit like, to know chi doesn't mean that you'll get the benefits of it. Just because you believe in it doesn't mean that it will work for you. We really have to gather chi and experience through our physical bodies, through this vehicle that we have here that's made out of chi. When we're healthy, chi is flowing and circulating in your body. When chi isn't circulating, when it gets stuck or blocked, we say that the chi gets stagnant. And this is like water. When water doesn't move, it's not healthy. So the goal of the practice, continually keep your chi circulating and flowing so that it animates and brings that life force into every single cell of your body. So let's start this session with an exercise called the Great Bear Swims in the Ocean. Now this is going to expand and bring energy into your lungs, and then let that energy spread through your upper back and neck all the way out through the arms. Palms face up here. Bend the knees. Let your tailbone just relax under. This is a Qigong stance that we continually want to come back to. Knees slightly bent, feet pointing straight ahead, and that tailbone relaxed. So nice long lengthening through the spine. Palms here. Push the hands forward. Turn, expand, and spiral the arms behind you. Now inhale as you open the arms. So here, filling up the lungs, filling up the chest. Exhale and sink the chest, push the arms forward. Synchronize the movement with your breathing. Exhale and inhale. And exhale and inhale. Now some of the finer points to this movement, when your arms go forward, your chest is sinking back so that you're making space in between your shoulder blades. So you're opening through the upper back, you're making space in the chest and through the rib cage. So here, sinking the chest and then expanding the chest. Really take that deep breath, fill the lungs up with the breath and with energy. Called Great Bear Swims in the Ocean. It's that swimming motion, but it's not just an arm movement. It's a breathing exercise that tonifies the lungs. It brings strength, power, and energy to the lungs. When the lungs fill up with more oxygen, we bring more energy to the body. When scientists study Qigong practitioners, they're finding that Qigong practitioners take in twice the amount of oxygen as normal breathers. So when you're breathing and doing this exercise, allow yourself to fill up the lungs with more breath and more energy. When you become a more efficient breather, your energy works more efficiently. Every single cell in your body needs oxygen to do its job. Inhale, fill up with that energy. Exhale, let go of old energy. Inhale, expand. Exhale, sink the chest. Good, and then relax. Now, palms face forward. We're going to do a movement that'll help to open your upper back and neck. It's a similar movement. You're going to come in front of you like this, spiral in, and then stretch out. So here your thumbs are turning face up, your shoulders press down, Try that again. So come in front of you, spiral in, so fingers point in towards your body, and then extend out. Shoulders press down, top of the head lifts, and we're opening a line of tension all the way through the neck and shoulders here. Inhale, gather energy, exhale, send it down through the arms, and lengthen. Inhale, and exhale. Inhale, and exhale. Now lean the head to one side. This area here, where we constantly hold tension and stress, is called a line of tension. So we're going to open that line of tension through this gentle stretch. The arm pressing away from you and the head leaning in the opposite direction. Slowly just roll your head back and forth across the shoulder. And feel the front of the neck when you're back here opening, and then the back of the neck when the chin comes forward. Now go chin down towards the chest, roll across to the other side, opening the line of tension down through the arm. So the arm spiraling, the head leaning, and then slowly and very gently roll the head back and forth. On this stretch, just let your head relax over. Don't feel like you have to push it over. Just let it relax and soften. Feel the front of the neck releasing tension, the back of the neck. The movement's like a good massage. It works tension out of the muscles. It lengthens and stretches those muscles and tendons as well. And then relax, arms down to the sides, and then feel. When you stretch and lengthen and clear tension, chi will naturally circulate. Eyes closed, deep breath. Notice how that feels down through the arms into the hands. It's amazing, you can feel this energy moving in your body with just a few exercises. Let's do the other side. So on that last one, we were stretching the line of tension on the outside of the arm and the neck. Now we'll do the opposite side. We want to keep yin and yang balanced in our bodies. So back of the hands are forward now. Go behind yourself. Spiral. And then here we're extending through the fingers and kind of turning the pinky finger over. Do that again. Back of the hands forward. Go behind yourself and extend. Inhale. Circle, exhale, and stretch. Inhale, and exhale. And take that stretch just a little bit deeper, ear towards the shoulder. Roll the head back and forth across the shoulder. Feel it opening the front of the neck, the chest, down the inside of the arms. These are great exercises for neck and shoulder tension, but also for preventing carpal tunnel, wrist problems, or tendonitis in the arms. Relax the head. Slowly let it roll back and forth across the shoulder. Go to the other side. Working out tension and tightness, slowly rolling the head back and forth. Nice deep breath. Then relax. Arms down to the sides. Notice how your body feels. Notice this flow of energy from the chest, neck and shoulders going down through the arms into your hands. Feeling and sensing that energy, that sensation, is the process of discovering qi. Once we feel it in our bodies, we can start to work with it at a deeper level. All right, so now that this is opened up, some tension and stress is cleared out of the muscles, we're starting to feel this life force energy circulating. Let's do another flowing movement to cultivate and bring this energy into our bodies in a deeper way. Hands down to the sides. And just inhale and float the arms up, just a little bit, and exhale and float the arms down. Inhale, float the arms up, and exhale down. Just take your arms up as far as the breath lifts the arms. So again, relax this area here. So it's a full deep breath and a long exhale. Bring the arms up through your breathing. This is called flying. Flying. Like wings of the bird, your arms float up on an inhale and float down on the exhale. As the arms come down, slightly bend your knees. As the arms float up, stand a little taller and just allow your whole body to participate in the movement. Inhale and breathe in relaxation. Exhale, let go of tension. Inhale, breathe in lightness, relaxation, and levity. Feel this sensation circulating in your body. Breathe the arms all the way up to the shoulders and down. Breathe the arms all the way up to the shoulders and relax down. Close your eyes and feel yourself becoming more relaxed with each breath. For energy to circulate in your body and to circulate efficiently, we need to relax and breathe in this light energy. Sometimes we get too heavy in our energy, too heavy in our minds, too serious in our emotions. Breathe in a lightness in through your heart center and let it circulate and flow through your body. Feel that flow of life force energy moving through the body, bringing healing life force to wherever you need it, bringing vitality into your body, bringing lightness into your heart, and a calm sense of relaxation into your spirit. Hands down to the sides. Close the eyes and take a moment to feel and sense and discover that qi inside your own body. After flowing movements, it should just settle in and feel a little bit deeper. Feel that inner tranquility, that inner peacefulness radiating from the inside out. Just see as you go through your day if you can bring some of this lightness and relaxation into the rest of your day, into your interactions, into whatever you have to do. Welcome to session 4. In this session, we're going to focus on the lungs. The lungs are called the commanders of qi. In qigong, we think of the lungs as the first place where qi enters into the body. So the way in which you breathe determines the quality of your internal energy. So just by becoming a better breather and a more efficient breather, we're going to take in more life force energy. One of the meanings of qi was life breath. There's a difference between breath and energy. Qi is sort of the energy that's extracted out of the breath. So when you take a nice deep breath in, there's a place, there's a magical thing that happens. Breath or air and oxygen that's out here transforms into life force energy and literally becomes part of you. the breath or those oxygen cells become part of your brain cells, your kidney cells, your heart cells, your thinking process. There's a magical transformation that happens between the energy externally and the energy internally. It's the same energy, but when it filters in through your body, it becomes personalized to you. So the way in which we breathe helps determine the quality of your own personal energy. The first exercise that we can do is just simply notice the way in which we're breathing. So if you close your eyes and just take a nice deep breath, and just notice where the breath, when it comes inside of you, turns into energy. There's a place inside where you can literally feel this happening. Eyes closed, deep breath. And if you pause just a little bit at the top of your inhale, so inhale, and then just hold the breath for just a moment, you'll feel chi starting to develop and cultivate inside your body. There's lots of different kinds of qi. So in Chinese medicine, qi that's derived from the breath is a particular kind of energy. Now we can go without food for quite a long time. We can go without drinking for a few days, but you can only go a few minutes without breathing. So breath is the quickest source of internal energy and life force. Let's open up this area, the chest, the lungs, and the heart center, so that when breath comes in, it's a more efficient process in extracting that life force energy. Right here on the center of the sternum, I want you to just tap lightly. Tap lightly. So start at the top of the sternum and just go downward. And then use both hands, go up and down the center of the sternum. These are pressure points here for emotional balance and also for the lungs and the heart. That's why when we're in stress or when we have emotional tension, our breath always changes. So if we have stress, we're going to usually constrict the breath and lock it up here and create tension and tightness in the neck and shoulders. So when you're knocking here, feel this stress pattern releasing out of the body. Up and down the sternum. And then just go over to one side. Right below the collarbone, these pressure points here are for the lungs. The lung meridian, the energy pathway, it comes from within the body and emerges. The first two lung points are right here, and then it flows down through the arm. So we'll knock like this, just over those lung points. Take a deep breath. These points right here are also good for your immune system. And then go to the other side. Stimulate those pressure points right below the collarbone. Back to the center of the chest. Go up and down. And take a deep breath. So you fill the lungs up, percuss the chest, and get that energy to disperse and move through the body, clear emotional stress, and open the chest and release tension. A little more vigorously now, up and down the sternum. And then let's follow the lung meridian line. It goes down the inside of the arm to the crease of the elbow, all the way down to the thumb. Do that again. So knock here, down the inside of the arm, open the palm, crease of the elbow, all the way to the thumb. And the other side. So knocking and following the pathway of that meridian line. Open the hand down the inside of the arm to the thumb. Releasing blockage along that flow of energy. One more time. One more time at the center of the chest. Fairly vigorously now. Take a deep breath. And then relax. Hands, let's just point them directly towards the lungs. Close the eyes. You'll feel that buzzing and tingling energy through the chest, down through the inside of the arms, into the hands. Breathe some light and energy into the lungs, feel that energy penetrating through all the cells of the lungs. Inhale, breathe the breath in, feel it transform into chi, feel that chi spread through the body. Breathing and becoming a more efficient breather not only gives you more vitality, but it prevents health problems from happening in the first place. Metabolism stronger when you're breathing deep, and the way in which energy circulates in the nervous system is much more efficient. One more deep breath. And relax. Now, palms face up. And inhale, take the hands up over the head. And exhale and come down. And inhale, take the hands up over the head. And exhale and come down. Opening up the lung meridian. Remember, we said it goes down from the chest to the inside of the hand to the thumb. So when your hands are up over the head, the fingers point towards each other and you extend through the thumb. Then you come down. So you bring the hands up over the head, fingers pointing towards each other, reach up through the thumb, hands point towards the lungs and the chest, and then pointing up. Inhale, hands point towards the chest and the lungs, up over the head. Exhale down. And now just lengthen out your breath. Inhale. Little pause at the top of the inhale. Exhale. Little pause at the bottom of the exhale. Think of your breath like the tide of the ocean. The ocean will come into the shore and then there'll be a lull or a pause, and then it returns back to the ocean. So the same way, when we're breathing, there's a little lull or a pause at the top of the inhale where you're pulling the chi out of the breath. Little pause at the bottom of the exhale. Little pause here at the top of the inhale. And when your breath is still, this is the process where you're drawing the chi out of the breath. Drawing the chi, the energy out of the breath. Relax, flow, let your arms move with the breath. Also, when your breath is still, when your breath relaxes, your mind automatically follows. Your mind relaxes, your mind calms down as the breath deepens. There's a direct relationship between your breath and the way in which you breathe and the way in which you think. So as you're slowing your breath down, your mind can calm down and relax. You cultivate mental clarity and focus. And your mind and body start to move together more harmoniously. Lengthen the breath a little bit more. Cultivating more energy happens by becoming a more efficient breather and drawing more chi out of the breath. One more time. And now bring one arm down and the other arm up. So we just push the hands to the sides like this, and then lean a little bit. So whatever arm is up, you're leaning in the opposite direction and opening and stretching into the sides of the ribs. And then switch. So one hand up, the other down. You're going to lean to the side and stretch opening the rib cage. So whatever arm is up, you're leaning in the opposite direction. And now flow. So hands coming in and then pressing out. So you see this arm spiral as they come in, the knees bend, and then the legs straighten and the hands push away from each other. Go ahead and inhale here, fill up the lungs and the rib cage. Exhale. And inhale and stretch. Exhale and flow. So here, energy is coiling in, and here, energy is expanding and opening. Bringing energy in, and letting that energy spread through the body. Inhale. And exhale. This is releasing tension out of the sides of the body, releasing tension through the rib cage, so that as you inhale, we have more room to take in that breath, more spaciousness in the body. And just let it flow. Bending the knees slightly here, straightening the legs, getting that stretch. Bring the hands back to the center. And go back to that lung exercise, inhale, and just feel that there's a little bit more room and space through the chest and the ribs. Relax into the flow. Really fill the body up with the breath. Relax, feel the body, feel the chi moving down the arms, down the lung meridian. Notice how the chest is more open and the breath and energy circulating down through the trunk and the torso, down the legs, all the way to the feet. As you cultivate energy, you'll notice that your mind becomes more present moment oriented. Your mind and your body start to meet and create this harmony and balance. So here this week, as you notice, pay attention during the day to your breathing. Even if you just take 2 or 3 nice long deep breaths periodically through the day, you'll be cultivating more energy and sort of planting a seed into this pattern that normally goes below our level of awareness. Most of the time we're not thinking about how we're breathing, we're just breathing in a particular pattern. But if you stop, pay attention, take 2 or 3 deep breaths during your day, you'll change that subconscious pattern so that you're actually breathing deeper when you're not thinking about it. Enjoy. Welcome to session 5. In today's sessions, we're going to really stretch our bodies out. We're going to really open the lines of tension to make sure that this chi we're cultivating circulates through the whole system. Now, there's 2 distinct kinds of chi that we're working on. One is how much energy we have, and the other is the quality of energy. How much energy, how much quantity of energy do we possess in our bodies? Think of your body as a container that we want to fill up with this life force energy. The reason we want to do that is for health, vitality, emotional balance, clearing stress and tension, and also mental clarity and feeling a sense of being connected. In Qigong, we call that our spiritual practice, our connection to nature, the universe, and even our connection with each other. How do we cultivate compassionate loving kindness? So when we do our practice, it's not just about physical exercise, it's the kind of energy that we want through our lives. Let's start with an exercise that's a little bit wider. Same exercise as we did in one of our previous sessions, knocking on the door of life, this time just with a wide stance. Now when you do it with a wide stance, it really works the energy in the legs, it opens the hips, and it will take the opening a little bit deeper into your spine. So we're going to shift the weight left and right, like this, and then as we shift the weight, we're going to go into knocking on the door of life. So shift the weight left and right, knock, one arm's in front of the body, the other is still knocking across your lower back. Weight shift to strengthen the legs and open the hips. The knocking, remember, stimulates pressure points for more energy. This is a nice warm-up. Personally, I really like starting the day with knocking on the door of life because it energizes the body. Take a nice deep breath, shift the weight, kind of turn, look over that shoulder. Open the spine, open the upper back and neck. Good, and then just slow it down. Slow it down and relax. Okay, with the feet wide, we're gonna do a movement called full body flow. It's gonna stretch all the lines of tension in the body. If you only could do one stretch, this is a good one to do because it opens both the front of the body, it opens the back of the body, it opens the chest, the ribs, and the abdomen. It also stretches the hamstrings and the hips and the whole spine. Hold the back of one hand and just bring the hands up over the head and reach up and back. So your hips press forward a little bit. Going to lightly squeeze the buttocks, stretch up and back, and that'll open the whole front of the body. Then come forward and stretch over into a forward bend, all the way over. Bend your knees and roll up and inhale. Exhale, go forward and stretch. Inhale, reach up. Straight legs, stretch over. Inhale. And exhale. Full body flow stretches all the major muscles in your body. Reach up, come up, and now turn your hips to one side. You don't have to turn your feet, just turn the hips, reach up and back, and then go down to one leg and stretch over. Go across to the other side, turn your hips to that side, and reach up and back. Then go down. Come across and reach up and back. This stretch is called opening the door of life. The first movement, we knocked on the door of life. here we're opening it because of the twisting and turning of the hips and the waist. It opens that lower back center, twisting and turning. So we're turning from here and reaching up and back, coming down and stretching through the hamstrings and the legs. When you stretch the hamstrings, it opens the line of tension into your lower back. Come down and across. And here, turn, twist, open the hips, reach up and back, lengthen through the spine. And back to the center. And bring your feet together. Shake it out a little bit. Okay, so knocking on the door of life, that one's called full body flow. Remember in Qigong, flexibility helps to increase the flow and the circulation of life force energy. There's a saying that flexibility in nature has life force. When things start to get brittle, stiff, and tight, there's a lack of life force energy. There's a lack of youthful vitality. So as you stretch, you're creating more youthful vitality in your body. So that not only does the energy flow better, but your body's healthier, more vibrant, and more alive. Bring the hands in front of you, and let's just push the hands apart. That. Have the back of the hands come towards each other. Roll up, and then push forward. Circle around, and come back down. This one's called Embrace the Tiger. Return to the mountain. Embrace the tiger means harnessing internal energy, internal power and strength. The tiger is a metaphor for strong, full energy. Return to the mountain. This is a metaphor for relaxation, calmness, and tranquility. So in Qigong, you want to combine deep, abundant energy, the tiger, with this idea of the mountain, calmness and tranquility in the mind. This is the balance between yin and yang. Abundant energy, deep relaxation. In modern life, we sort of reverse that. We have stressful mind and stressful emotions and lack of energy and fatigue in our bodies. Here in Qigong practice, we're going to reverse that. We're going to increase the vitality in the body, but calm the mind so that the body stays harmonious and in balance. Embrace the tiger, return to the mountain. So the flow goes like this. Out, comes up. We push forward, and then we circle around. So it's a combination of some of the other flows that we've done. We've done the fountain in a previous session. So this Embrace the Tiger has that element of a wave moving up the spine and out through the arms. And then it also has this idea of the great bear swimming in the ocean where we're sinking the chest. So here, start with the hands, palms facing towards each other. And push apart, wave up through the spine, push forward, and then circle. Embrace the tiger, return to the mountain. Harness your internal energy. Calm your mind so that you can relax into the present moment. Inhale, bring the arms up. Exhale, push forward. Inhale, long inhale, all the way around. Exhale, push the hands apart. Inhale. Exhale. Long inhale. Exhale, push the hands apart. Inhale and breathe in that abundant energy. Feel your mind relax and calm. Rebalance, rebalancing your internal energy with flowing movements. Remember, when we're doing flowing movements, we're moving the body in this water-like fashion. See, your body is made out of water. It's over 70% water. We're just tuning into what's already there and using that inner principle as a relaxation method. Let yourself flow, relax. And as that water-like energy moves through you, It's a cohesive principle. It helps to let your chi move together harmoniously. Slow it down a little bit, flow. Wave up the spine, out through the arms. Synchronize the breath, the movement, your mind and body together. And as you're doing this flowing movement, just allow your mind to connect to the energy around you. Feel the way energy circulates inside the body and outside. So we're inhaling and drawing that chi in from around us, and then with the movement, allowing it to circulate. Use these flowing movements as a form of meditation. Meditation on your life force energy. A meditation that calms your mind and charges up your body. Round. And hands down to the sides. Bring your feet a little closer together. And notice how your body feels. We've stretched and opened, cleared lines of tension, and went through a little bit of a longer flowing routine to cultivate that sense of flow and fluidity through the body. And now just pay attention, notice, turn your senses inward and feel the flow of chi, the activation of energy. Good. Relax and enjoy. This is our final session, and through the course, you've learned certain things and fundamental principles about Qigong. You've gained some wisdom on what Qi is, maybe a little bit about the history and the practice of Qigong, but truly, the experience of Qi is where the discovery is. Qigong and the process of discovering Qi is an internal journey, the journey where you discover your own life force energy, how this life force energy can truly and fundamentally help you in health and healing, in cultivating resources, your own internal energy to guide and direct your life in the way that you want. Qi is that underlying principle of everything. It's what animates your body, but it also gives life meaning and purpose. So as you cultivate more energy and tap into these resources, not only will you feel better, but you'll have a sense of being guided on track and on purpose in life. In Qigong, we call this being in the flow. Being in the flow. And your practice, the practice of doing Qigong, is the training for being in the flow, and your life is the process where that flow unfolds. So hopefully you're enjoying the process of discovering Qi. In this final session, we'll wrap it up, we'll summarize it a little bit, we'll give you a few new techniques and tools. I'd encourage you to continue to go back to session one and go through the course a few times, and every time you do the exercises, you discover Qi in a little bit different way. It's not about just doing it once, it's about making it part of your daily life, part of a routine, and where that Qi grows. Like planting seeds, that Qi develops roots and reaches up and gathers in more energy. So as you change, your practice changes. Some of the principles that we've been working on over these weeks have been the practice of relaxation. The practice of feeling energy flowing through your body. This is the water-like principle. Other principles have been working on moving from the center and being centered in our emotions. Centering truly is about the earth principle. It's about being grounded. And when we move from our center, it helps our bodies to really and literally come from a place of power and strength. Another principle that we've been working on is how to breathe properly, how to extract chi from the air. So this is the principle of energy. And we want to be moving through our lives and through our practice with much more vitality and life force. So let's put that all together to truly create a practice that leads to enjoyment. This is the path of the heart, where we find joyful happiness through all our daily activities. Begin by taking a stance that's shoulder width apart. This is an exercise called spinal cord breathing. It's part of our spinal cord enlivening Qigong set. Now this exercise helps to circulate energy through the nervous system, but it also helps to clear stress and tension. It's a really nice exercise to do at the end of the day to unwind, to release stress and tension out of the body, and also come back to a place of balance and centering. Hands by the shoulders. As you inhale, we're gonna open the chest and look up. And then as you exhale, the chin goes down towards the chest, the elbows come towards each other, the fists are relaxed and loose, round the back. So again, open the chest, look up and inhale, round the back, elbows come towards each other, exhale. With the lower back, as you round, the tailbone tucks under. So we make space through the door of life and the kidneys. And then as you open, the tailbone arches out, a little bit of a ducktail. So from here and here. So this is called the sacral pump. We're pumping energy and that spinal fluid up through the spine and then activating the cranial pump, getting the cranial sacral system to find balance and energy. Inhale, open the chest. Exhale, round the back. Inhale and exhale. Now as you do this movement, keep both knees bent. So don't straighten the legs and bend the knees as you do this. Keep them bent through the whole exercise and focus the movement and the energy into your spine. Inhale and exhale. Feel the range of motion, the movement of the spine. Feel the mobility of all the joints in the back. Breathe relaxing energy into the nervous system. Just allow the body to recharge and rebalance. And then relax. So you can use that exercise anytime through the day where you feel like you need to clear a little stress and tension out of your body, or you just need a general recharge. Sitting at your desk, just stand up and move the spine, or you can even do it sitting down. It's a really practical, beneficial Qigong exercise. The next exercise, we're gonna do a variation of the shaking that we did. Shaking is a great exercise to clear stress and tension and charge up the body. We do this intuitively. Athletes shake before events. Children bounce and shake all the time. Intuitively in our bodies, it helps to process and circulate the flow of energy. Now we're going to do it in a way which stimulates a little bit deeper energy and makes that energy circulate stronger to tonify the body's internal energy. The way to do this is that you're gonna bounce the heels. You're gonna make contact with the heels onto the floor. So the weight is a little bit forward onto the toes and you bounce and knock the heels into the floor. Okay, so weight shifted onto the toes just a little bit. And then when you shake, knock the heels into the floor. You'll feel that vibration through the bones of the body. Now the wrists are gonna flap like this. It's gonna pump and circulate energy through the arms. So we have the leg pumps and the energy moving through the meridians of the legs and the arm pumps moving the energy through the meridians of the arms. So relax like this. Bounce the heels. It takes a little practice to get used to this movement. It'll actually really work the calf muscles. Then relax your neck. Relax your low back and the spine. And take a couple of deep breaths. Inhale. Long exhale. Inhale through the nose and exhale out through the mouth. And with this heel knocking, you can do this for 1 or 2 minutes to charge the body's energy system. And just sort of scan your body. Notice anywhere you're holding stress and tension. Try to bring that vibration, that shaking into that area. Maybe between your shoulders, through the spine, your low back. Keep the wrists pumping and circulating, and those heels knocking into the floor. You'll really feel the energy after this exercise. Inhale through the nose. Exhale out through the mouth. One more time. Slow it down and relax. Feel the chi inside your body. Feel the energy moving and circulating. Eyes closed. Feel the energy through the legs. Feel the energy moving in the spine. Down the arms to the hands. Some nice, light, relaxing energy moving up into the head. The whole body filling up with chi. Remember, we're using our mind, turning our attention inward, discovering chi through the conscious process of paying attention. One more deep breath. Good, here, inhale, bring the hands up to the sides. Exhale, hands come down. This is called pulling down the heavens. This allows you to open up and receive the energy from all around you. In Qigong, we think of nature as being unlimited in the amount of energy. Through the process of relaxation, feel yourself opening up, being receptive to all the energy that's around you. What kind of energy do you want to cultivate today? Feel like you need more vitality or more relaxation? You need creative energy? Do you need loving energy? Just be open to receive that. Create a state of receptivity, expansiveness, and pull that quality of energy through you. Inhale, hands come up. Exhale, nice wave of relaxation moving down through the body. Moving down from the head, down through the torso, down out through the legs. As we do our Qigong practice, we become more resourceful on how much and what kind of energy we want to cultivate. The quantity and the quality of our energy. Use your mind to pull in the kind of energy that you want. We open, and with our intention, we draw in that positive energy. Let yourself just fill up. And then bring both hands over your lower abdomen. So just bring the hands right over the navel and bring your feet a little closer together. And then allow all that energy just to settle in. Settle into your center. Eyes closed. Again, pay attention. Notice how your body feels. Energy is all around you through nature, in the sky, in the earth. That same energy is inside you. feel that energy inside you, circulating, keeping you healthy and happy, keeping you fulfilled from the inside out.
To welcome you to this Qigong routine for more energy. It's going to be about 10 minutes long and it's designed to give you that boost of energy that you might need in the morning or anytime during the day where you feel like you need just a little pickup. All right, the first exercise is called knocking on the door of life. I want you to stand with your knees slightly bent. You're going to relax your neck and shoulders and just start turning from your hips and your waist and let your arms knock across your lower abdomen. And let your arms knock across the lower back. The door of life is an acupressure point directly between the two kidneys around the second lumbar vertebra. And this point gives you a lightning flash of vitality to give you more energy for your day. So go ahead, take a deep breath and let your arms knock across that lower back and knock across the lower abdomen. We're going to stimulate some vital acupressure points to give you that energy that you need through your day. Go ahead and take a nice deep breath. Turn from your hips and your waist. And just relax your upper back, neck, and shoulders. If you want to give you a little more flexibility in your spine, you just gently turn, look over that shoulder. I'm going to open up the spine. Take one more deep breath. And just let your body kind of unwind all by itself. Come back to the center and take a deep breath. Good. The next one is something called the tiger. Again, it's an exercise to bring more energy into your body. So bring your hands up over your head. Here's our inhale. Then exhale and bend your knees. Come down. Inhale. Reach up. Bend your knees on that exhale. Come down towards the floor. This will strengthen your legs and tonify your kidneys. It opens and stretches the hips and the lower back. So here, inhale and exhale down. A tiger to bring that power and energy and vitality into your day. Stretching, strengthening the legs, opening through the lower back. You're gonna inhale here through the nose and exhale out through the mouth. Inhale through the nose, exhale through the mouth. This will help to release that tiger energy in your body. Good, inhale and exhale. Now if you can, you can come down just a little bit lower and sink into your heels and then come up. Make sure on this one you feel comfortable in your knees and your legs. And you can always just go down a little bit, not too far, and get that same benefit. Last one. And arms out to the sides. Good. You'll feel that speeding up your heartbeat, warming up your body, and bringing that energy up to the surface. Next one we're going to do is something called chi massage. Here, I want you to knock over your kidneys. Again, this is the door of life area, so it's going to bring out that energy in your body. Think of some of these exercises as a way to give your body that natural boost of energy. And then from the kidneys, I want you to just slap down the back of the legs and up the inside of the legs. So you're going to come from here and go down the outside and the back of the legs and up the inside of the legs. From your kidneys, you go down the outside, up the inside, and then come to your chest and knock right here over the chest. Take a nice deep breath. This will open the energy to your lungs and to your heart for good circulation. Nice deep breath and a long exhale. Then slap down the inside of the arm. slap up the outside of the arm, kind of right there to your neck and shoulders. And do that again. Down the meridians, the energy pathways down the inside of the arm. Come up the outside of the arm. Come over to the other side. Slap up the inside. Come down. Up the outside to the neck and shoulders. And then back to the chest. These points here will be really beneficial to your immune system as well, increasing the energy to the lungs, the heart, and even the thymus gland. Take one deep breath. Exhale and relax. And now just close the eyes and you can feel this energy start to awaken in your body. This is what we call qi. Feel the qi circulating down through the arms into your hands, down the legs to the feet. Very nice. All right. Next exercise. Let's do one. This is called Buddha Holding Up the Earth. Buddha Holding Up the Earth. It's a breathing exercise designed to tonify and strengthen your lungs. So here, arms are round, your knees are bent. Inhale, bring your hands up over your head. And you're going to reach the palms up over the head, thumbs extend, and then exhale and come down. Good. Inhale and we come up. Exhale and come down. If you want more energy in your body for health, wellness, more energy in your life, one excellent way to start is by deep breathing. So lengthen the breath here. Inhale, bring your hands all the way up over your head. Little pause at the top of the inhale and then exhale all the way out. Exhale all the way out. And nice deep breath. And a long exhale. Good. Inhale. Little pause here. Let your body fill up with this energy. Exhale and come down. Do it one more time. Deep breath and exhale down. Good. Now that the body's energy is open and circulating, let's go into a nice flowing sequence that will bring you into a nice harmonious rhythm in your body. Your hands are going to be here in front of you. We're going to open the hands out. Then the back of the hands come towards each other. Roll up. Push forward. And then circle. This is called embrace the tiger, return to the mountain. Out. Rolling up. Push forward. Inhale as you circle around. Good. Exhale. We're going to open the hands. A little flowing movement up the spine. Exhale. Push forward. Inhale and circle the hands. Exhale. And inhale, exhale, and then this is a long deep breath. Gather your energy, exhale out, embrace the tiger, return to the mountain. This one harnesses internal energy. Embrace the tiger, cultivate your power and your strength. At the same time, return to the mountain. Keep that energy calm and relaxed, clear. Return to the mountain also means come back to your center, your place of harmony and balance. So in Qigong, what we want to cultivate is both the combination of abundant energy and mental clarity, deep vital energy plus inner balance and harmony. Let it flow through your body. Let it flow through the body. One more time. To your center. And now let's bring the feet a little closer together. One hand under your abdomen, the other is going to circle. This will bring a state of mental clarity and inner balance and harmony. This one is excellent for mental focus and just gathering your energy and your resources. You can use this one before a meeting, as a way to get clarity, set clear intention, and start your day empowered, full of strength, and with clear mental focus. It's called centering. Inhale as the arm circles. Exhale and come down the front of the body. Inhale and circle. Exhale and come down. Feel your mind and your heart and your body's energy in harmony and balance. One more time. And then just bring both hands over your lower abdomen. Close your eyes and feel that wonderful combination of energy and relaxation. Great, and enjoy the rest of your day.
Welcome to this 20-minute Qigong routine. This one, again, is for more energy, designed to give you that lightning flash of vitality that we all want to start our day, or just anytime you want a little bit more energy and vitality, this will be a great routine. Let's start by bending the knees. We're gonna do a movement called knocking on the door of life. You're gonna turn from your hips and your waist. Relax your shoulders and just let your arms knock across your lower back and across your lower abdomen. Go ahead and take a nice deep breath. These pressure points across the lower back and around the lower abdomen are designed for more energy. Now, the movement of your spine helps to create suppleness and flow and flexibility through the spine. Again, take a deep breath, relax your shoulders, keep those knees bent, feel centered and balanced, and enliven the spine with the movement. You can just gently turn, look over one shoulder, and feel that stretching and opening your upper back. Now from here, let's go into another pressure point. Just bring one hand just below the collarbone and knock on the chest. These points are for your lungs, designed to bring more energy into your body. So take a deep breath. These points are also good for your immune system. Make your body stronger. It's like your Qigong flu shot. Keep you healthy and strong and vital. One more acupressure point that we'll do in this exercise. Let's come up over the shoulder and knock on the top of the shoulder. This one brings energy, circulation, and flow into the neck, upper back, and into the head. This point here is said to help make good decisions because as the chi opens from the neck and shoulders and goes to the head, we have clearer energy in the mind for decision making. Good. Now come back down, knock on the chest and the lower back. Little turn, look over the shoulder, stretch the spine. Slow it down, slow it down, and relax. Goody. Now bring the hands up over the head, take a deep breath, and we'll exhale and come down into a movement called the tiger. Bend your knees here. And come up, inhale, and just go as low as you can, comfortably. Go as low as you can. If you can sink all the way down, that's great. If not, just come down as far as you can comfortably. Good, inhale, come up. This will strengthen your legs, open your hips and your waist. Bring energy and vitality up through the body. Here, you're cleansing your internal organs, and then you come down towards the earth, towards the ground. Inhale and feel here any energy you no longer need. Just bring it down to the earth and then take it up. Exhale, old energy. Inhale, new energy. It's kind of a flushing and a cleansing exercise as well as a strength and an energy enhancer. Inhale through the nose. Exhale out through the mouth. One more time. Take a deep breath and exhale. Very good. All right. Next one, let's do some chi massage. Again, stimulate acupressure points for more energy and vitality. We're going to start here at the door of life and the kidney area. Go up and down your lower back. Up and down this area. Your adrenal glands are right here and your kidneys. This is the door of life. Down to the tailbone. Stimulate those points. Now the meridians and the energy pathways go from the lower back down the outside of the leg. So here, with both hands, simultaneously go down the outside of your legs. And then come up the inside of the legs to your hips and your waist. Do that again. Slap down the outside of the legs. Come up the inside. And then right here on your hips, this knock on the hips. This is called the leg gates. It promotes good circulation through the legs and down to the feet. And now up to the chest. Knock on your chest. Take a nice deep breath. Hold the breath at the top of the inhale. Hold and turn the breath into more energy. Then exhale. Do that again. Inhale. Hold the breath. Knock a little stronger. Turn that breath into energy. Exhale. One more time. Exhale. Now, slap down the inside of the arm. This is the flow of the meridians as they come down the inside. And now up the outside to the neck and shoulder. Knock down the inside of the arm. Come up the outside of the arm. Knock there on the neck and shoulder area. Free up some tension. Come across to the other side and knock. Up the outside of the arm to the neck and shoulders. On this little knocking routine, we're freeing up the flow of chi, turning tension back into flow. Back to the chest. One more deep breath. Exhale all the way out. Hands down to the sides. Feel your energy open, awake, circulating. And just start to shake it out. Shake your wrists and your elbows and your shoulders. That's it. And bounce into your heels a little bit. And just shake the whole body. And this is going to transform stress. Anywhere you're holding tension or tightness in the body, it transforms it back into vital energy. You have a tremendous amount of energy already inside yourself. So we want to release it, free it up, and access your own inner potential. So here, take a deep breath through the nose. We're going to exhale out through the mouth. And completely relax into that shaking. Anywhere you hold tension or tightness in your body, free it up with the movement. Relax right through the back of the neck. Relax your hips and your waist. Relax the neck and shoulders. One more deep breath. This exercise transforms stress into vitality. And we can feel it. Just stop. Do a little check-in. Close your eyes. Notice the energy flow down your arms to your hands, down the legs to the feet. Tingling, buzzing electricity. This is your chi. Now bring your hands in front of you, arms around, bend your knees, and we'll go into some qigong flowing movements. This one tonifies your lungs. Inhale, bring your hands up. Exhale and come down. Slow the breath down. Let it be full and deep. If you want more energy, one of the best places to start is with your breathing. Deepen the breath, make it longer and slower. Exhale. Try having a little pause at the top of the inhale. Turn the breath into life force. This one's called Buddha, holding up the earth. designed to calm the mind and recharge the body. Again. Now take one hand down and the other up. And whatever hand is down, you're going to lean to that side and stretch and open the ribs. Stretch the lateral side of the body. Take a deep breath here. And then spiral in, and then other side. Press the palms away from each other. Lean a little bit to the side. Whatever hand is down, you're going to lean into that side. Press the palms away. Open the meridians through the rib cage. Take a deep breath. And this upper hand, bring it down. You're going to spiral it in so your pinky finger faces towards you. Bend your knees. Now straighten the legs. Press the palms away from each other. Inhale and exhale. Stretch and a flow, opening the yin and yang meridians of the body, opening the rib cage and deepening the breath. When you stretch the rib cage, we can actually breathe deeper. Inhale, expand, lean, stretch, exhale, come in, let it flow, stretch, and flow. Come back to your center, hands down to the sides. Take a nice deep breath and just feel that expansion through your chest and your rib cage. Go ahead and close your eyes. Notice how your body feels. The next movement we dive into is called the fountain. Now this is going to open up your body into flow. Flowing movements in Qigong really activate the energy and the meridians. Okay, here, bring the back of your hands towards each other. Your hips glide back a little bit. And then we're going to wave up through the spine and out through the arms. Hips glide back, back of the hands towards each other. Tuck your tailbone under slightly and wave up through the spine. It's like a wave rolling up through the spine and out through the arms. If I turn to the side, hips glide back. Tuck the tailbone, roll up through the spine, out through the arms. And feel this flow activating the energy in your body. Goes up the spine, out through the arms. Feel it as a water-like movement through the body. Tapping into your flow. Qigong is often called the art of effortless power. So feel that flow active in your body. Feel that water-like fluidity moving up your spine and out through the arms. Inhale as you come up. Exhale out to the sides. Now just start to relax muscles in your body that feel tight. Start to relax into your flow. Relax your upper back, your neck, and your shoulders. Inhale as you come up. And exhale out. Just start to slow it down now. Feel the energy increase in the body. Soft and relax. We use relaxation to create flow. Flow in the body and then relaxation in your mind. Take one more deep breath. Exhale out to the sides. And then from the fountain, we're going to expand the movement into embrace the tiger, return to the mountain. So your hands are here. You're going to go out to the sides. And this is the fountain movement. We roll up the spine and now push forward. And then circulate all the way around. Okay, so here, go back with your hips. Tuck under with the tailbone, roll up the spine. Push forward with the hands and circle around. The breathing is exhale as you go out. Inhale as you roll up. Exhale forward. And a nice deep breath all the way around. Exhale. Draw that flow and energy up the spine. Sink the chest to relax your heart center. Inhale and bring in power and energy to your center. Embrace the tiger. This is about harnessing internal energy, confidence, poise, and power. Breathe it in. Breathe in your energy and your power. Let go of limitations and blockages. And then return to the mountain. Harness your sense of self. Bring the energy and power to your center. Calm and relax your mind. Qigong is a wonderful combination of energy, flow, power, and relaxation. So let this movement now flow through your body. One more time. Exhale out. Inhale up. Exhale. Nice deep breath. Back to the center. Now we're going to expand this one more stage. Let these flows unfold. This one is the earth flow. It's a little bit longer. Same opening movement. Arms go out. Roll up. Push forward. And then this one, your arms are out to the sides and you create a nice protective field of energy around your body. Spiral the arms behind you and sink to the earth. Sink down. And scoop up the earth energy. And then make a ball. Make a ball like this. And then pick up this ball of energy and glide it through the body. And this cleanses and clears any old energy, transforms it into vitality. Float the arms up and down. Let's try it again. From here, glide your hips back. A little wave-like quality up the spine. Push forward. And field of protective energy around your body, keeping you protected, balanced, and energized. Feel grounded as you sink down towards the earth. Fingers expanded. Scoop up that earth energy. And then make this healing ball of light. This energy ball here. You can visualize it as golden light. And then you're going to lift it and feel it cleanse, clear, awaken your body's internal energy. Down the legs to the floor. Inhale. And exhale. Holding a ball. Expand here. Hips glide back. Fountain-like movement up the spine. Push forward. Protective ball of energy around you. Spiral. Connect to the earth. Scoop up that earth energy and make a ball of light. Pick up that ball of light. Cleanse, clear. Any areas that you need extra healing or wellness, infuse them with energy. Float up and down. Hips glide back. Inhale as you come up. Push forward. Protective field of energy around you so that you don't take on other people's energy. You stay strong, centered, and balanced in your own energy field. Connect to the earth. Scoop it up. Ball of healing light. Infuse every cell in your body with a little extra healing energy and power. Float the arms up and down. One more time. Push forward. Healing energy around you. Connect to the earth. Scoop it up. Create a ball. And infuse yourself with extra energy. Good. Now have your hands face towards each other and just bring the hands a little closer together, a little further apart, and feel your energy. Feel that electromagnetic energy, that chi radiating between your hands. This creates that feeling of hands of light, healing hands. Sometimes in Qigong, this is referred to as Buddha palm. Now bring your feet a little closer together. Hand under the abdomen and centering. Inhale. Bring that hand straight down the midline. Exhale. And inhale. And exhale. Take all that energy to your center. And we create that nice harmony between body, mind, and spirit. And this one is a great way to just bring clarity to the mind and energy to your body. Centering. Mind and heart center and body center in balance, in alignment. Your thoughts, your emotions, and your body in harmony and balance. Do that one more time. Take a deep breath. And then put both hands over your lower abdomen. Close your eyes. And here, just let your body rock and sway. Let yourself soak up that energy. Connect to your center. This is called bamboo in the wind. Just gently rock and sway. Rock and sway. Relax your legs. Relax your hips and your waist. This one will unwind any tension or tightness in your body and bring you back to that place of being centered and balanced. Close the eyes, gently rock and sway. Let your body rock and sway just however it's most comfortable. Unwind to your place of power, to your center. Take one more deep breath. Excellent. And take that feeling with you into the rest of your day. Thanks for joining me.
Welcome to the Qigong routine for the evening. Now, this routine is going to help you clear stress and tension out of your body, and it's a nice routine for transitions from your work day to coming home, or even from your day to going to sleep. So let's start with an exercise called spinal cord breathing. You're going to have your hands up here by your shoulders. Inhale and look up, open your chest, and exhale, round your back, tuck your tailbone under. Inhale, open your chest. Exhale, round your back, tuck your tailbone under. This movement with the deep breathing and the spinal cord movement and flow will help to clear tension out of the nervous system. Take a nice deep breath and look up. Exhale, round your back, tuck your tailbone under. Deep breathing and spinal cord movements will help to transform stress into vitality. It switches your nervous system from a stress response into a relaxation response. Again, deep breath, inhale, a little bit longer, fill up the chest, round the back, send some energy to the spine. Feel the way your joints move, feel the articulation of the joints in the spine. Here, the front of the spine opens, and then the back of the spine opens, creating strength and flexibility through the back. Nice deep breath. Round the back. And relax. Good. Bring your hands down to your sides. Next movement is going to be like knocking on the door of life, but here we're going to just swirl the hands around. They're not going to touch the body. This will bring energy out of the head and into the body. It'll calm and relax your mind. This is called water waves. So your hand comes out and then swirls around, like your fingers are gliding through the surface of water. Hand comes out and swirls around. And this will bring the energy down to your center. Move from your hips and your waist. Keep your neck and shoulders real relaxed. No tension or tightness in the neck and shoulders. The arms just floating out. Feel the air move through your fingers. And let your mind just relax into the movement. The breath is gentle and soft and full. Turn your hips and your waist. relaxed. Swirl the energy around your center. Feel this dropping your energy out of your head, down through your body, and connecting to your center. Deep breath. Slow it down. Slow it down. Take your hands down by your sides. If you close your eyes and just tune into your energy, you can start to feel this chi awakening in your body. Bring your palms forward, hands and arms in front of you, and extend towards the floor. Good. Here, inhale. Gather that energy. Exhale down the meridian lines. Tuck your chin back and in. Hips glide back as your hands come forward. And extend and stretch, spreading the feathers. One more time. Exhale, extend and stretch. Go ear to the shoulder. And then let's roll the head to the back of the shoulder. And roll the head forward towards the front of the shoulder. The movement is like a good massage, working out tension and tightness out of the neck area. Gets those deep knots or muscle contractions, gets them to release and freeze up tension, and turns it back into energy and circulation. Chin to the chest. Cross over to the other side and roll the head back and roll the head forward. Nice deep breath. Exhale all the way out. Clear tension and tightness out of the neck and shoulders. Long exhale. One more time. Roll the head back. Chin down. And relax. And now just feel that energy. It's going to go down those meridian lines and awaken the chi in your hands. Close the eyes, take a deep breath. Great, now bring your hands in front of you, palms face up. This is called the bear swimming in the ocean. You're gonna go out with your hands and turn and stretch the meridian lines, the energy pathways through the arms, spiral behind you, and then extend out. Inhale here, and exhale. Inhale, open the chest, and then when you exhale, let your chest sink back and stretch. This one, again, strengthens the lungs, opens the meridians of the arms, and it'll open the space right between the shoulder blades. There's a point right between the shoulder blades called the point that treats 100 problems, and this one helps to awaken and move energy through that area. Deep breathing, exhale forward. Inhale back, exhale. Try to lengthen your breath now. Use the breath to clear stress out of the body. Transition from being in a busy kind of space inside yourself from your day to calming the energy and creating that nice relaxation and chi response. Inhale and exhale. One more time. Hands come down to your sides. Now connect this deep breathing to a movement in the arms and in the shoulders. So when you inhale, your arms are going to float up to your sides. And exhale, come down. And inhale, stand just a little taller here. Expand your energy and then exhale, bend your knees slightly. This one's called flying. It brings lightness, relaxation, levity into your energy, into your mind and body. Inhale, arms float up just a little higher and exhale down. Feel like your breath is lifting your arms, no tension in the shoulders. Flying and breathe in relaxation. Here, let go of stress and tension. Let go of your worries. Drop your mind into the present moment. You can do this by just feeling the air move through your fingers and across your arms. Feel your body moving through space. Inhale, float the arms all the way up to the shoulders. Exhale and come down. If you'd like to, you can close your eyes and just experience this energy pulsing and moving through your body. Breathe in relaxation. Exhale stress, tension, any worries. Just feel them release. Elevate yourself above your challenges and your worries. Let your energy relax and elevate. Close the eyes. Arms float up on the inhale, stand a little taller. Exhale, come down. Feel as if you're breathing in lightness, letting go of anything that feels heavy in your energy system. Now, one more time. Now, take your arms all the way up above your head. Inhale, coming up. Palms face towards you and exhale, come down. Glide the energy through your body. Inhale, coming up. This is called pulling down the heavens. And it creates a nice wave of relaxing energy downward through the body. During the day when we're really busy, energy has a tendency to rise up to the head and create a lot of thinking and thinking process or agitated or turbulent mind. This will be a nice remedy for that. It'll calm your mind, relax your body, and allow yourself to recharge. This one's a nice one to do before going to sleep, to calm the mind and bring in that relaxing energy that you need for rest. Pulling down the heavens. Arms float up on the inhale. Exhale, come down. Go ahead and close your eyes, just relax, feel a nice wave of relaxing energy moving downward through your body. Do that one more time, nice deep breath. And bring both hands over your lower abdomen. Go ahead and bring your feet together and just take a few deep breaths all the way down into your belly. Let everything settle in and relax. When you inhale, let the belly expand, let the breath come down. Exhale all the way out. Do that one more time. And just feel that peace and tranquility ripple through your whole system. Welcome to the Qigong routine for the evening. Now this routine is going to help you clear stress and tension out of your body, and it's a nice routine for transitions from your work day to coming home, or even from your day to going to sleep. So let's start with an exercise called spinal cord breathing. You're going to have your hands up here by your shoulders. Inhale and look up, open your chest, and exhale, round your back, tuck your tailbone under. Inhale, open your chest. Exhale, round your back, tuck your tailbone under. This movement with the deep breathing and the spinal cord movement and flow will help to clear tension out of the nervous system. Take a nice deep breath and look up. Exhale, round your back, tuck your tailbone under. Deep breathing and spinal cord movements will help to transform stress into vitality. It switches your nervous system from a stress response into a relaxation response. Again, deep breath, inhale, a little bit longer, fill up the chest, round the back, send some energy to the spine. Feel the way your joints move, feel the articulation of the joints in the spine. Here the front of the spine opens, and then the back of the spine opens, creating strength and flexibility through the back. Nice deep breath, round the back, and relax. Good, bring your hands down to your sides. Next movement is gonna be like knocking on the door of life, but here we're gonna just swirl the hands around. They're not gonna touch the body. This will bring energy out of the head and into the body. It'll calm and relax your mind. This is called water waves. So your hand comes out and then swirls around, like your fingers are gliding through the surface of water. Hand comes out and swirls around. And this will bring the energy down to your center. Move from your hips and your waist. Keep your neck and shoulders real relaxed. No tension or tightness in the neck and shoulders. The arms just floating out. Feel the air move through your fingers. And let your mind just relax into the movement. The breath is gentle and soft and full. Turn your hips and your waist. Relax. Swirl the energy around your center. Feel this dropping your energy out of your head, down through your body, and connecting to your center. Deep breath. Slow it down. Slow it down. Take your hands down by your sides. If you close your eyes and just tune into your energy, you can start to feel this chi awakening in your body. Bring your palms forward, hands and arms in front of you, and extend towards the floor. Good. Here, inhale. Gather that energy. Exhale down the meridian lines. Tuck your chin back and in. Hips glide back as your hands come forward. And extend and stretch, spreading the feathers. One more time. Exhale, extend and stretch. Go ear to the shoulder. And then let's roll the head to the back of the shoulder and roll the head forward towards the front of the shoulder. The movement is like a good massage, working out tension and tightness out of the neck area. Gets those deep knots or muscle contractions, gets them to release and freeze up tension and turns it back into energy and circulation. Chin to the chest, cross over to the other side and roll the head back. And roll the head forward. Nice deep breath. Exhale all the way out. Clear tension and tightness out of the neck and shoulders. Long exhale. One more time. Roll the head back. Chin down. And relax. And now just feel that energy. It's going to go down those meridian lines and awaken the chi in your hands. Just close the eyes. Take a deep breath. Great. Now bring your hands in front of you, palms face up. This is called the bear swimming in the ocean. You're going to go out with your hands and turn and stretch the meridian lines, the energy pathways through the arms, spiral behind you. And then extend out. Inhale here. And exhale. Inhale, open the chest. And then when you exhale, let your chest sink back and stretch. This one, again, strengthens the lungs, opens the meridians of the arms, and it'll open the space right between the shoulder blades. There's a point right between the shoulder blades called the point that treats 100 problems, and this one helps to awaken and move energy through that area. Deep breathing, exhale forward. Inhale back. Exhale. Try to lengthen your breath now. Use the breath to clear stress out of the body. Transition from being in a busy kind of space inside yourself from your day to calming the energy and creating that nice relaxation and chi response. Inhale and exhale. One more time. Hands come down to your sides. Now connect this deep breathing to a movement in the arms and in the shoulders. So when you inhale, your arms are going to float up to your sides and exhale, come down. And inhale, stand just a little taller here. Expand your energy and then exhale, bend your knees slightly. This one's called flying. It brings lightness, relaxation, levity into your energy, into your mind and body. Inhale, arms float up just a little higher, and exhale down. Feel like your breath is lifting your arms, no tension in the shoulders. Flying in, breathe in relaxation. Here, let go of stress and tension. Let go of your worries. Drop your mind into the present moment. You can do this by just feeling the air move through your fingers and across your arms. Feel your body moving through space. Inhale, float the arms all the way up to the shoulders. Exhale and come down. If you'd like to, you can close your eyes and just experience this energy pulsing and moving through your body. Breathe in relaxation. Exhale, stress, tension, any worries, just feel them release. Elevate yourself above your challenges and your worries. Let your energy relax and elevate. Close the eyes. Arms float up on the inhale, stand a little taller. Exhale, come down. Feel as if you're breathing in lightness, letting go of anything that feels heavy in your energy system. Now one more time. Now take your arms all the way up above your head. Inhale, coming up, palms face towards you, and exhale, come down. Glide the energy through your body. Inhale, coming up. This is called pulling down the heavens, and it creates a nice wave of relaxing energy downward through the body. During the day, when we're really busy, energy has a tendency to rise up to the head and create a lot of thinking and thinking process or agitated or turbulent mind. This will be a nice remedy for that. It'll calm your mind, relax your body, and allow yourself to recharge. This one's a nice one to do before going to sleep, to calm the mind and bring in that relaxing energy that you need for rest. Pulling down the heavens. Arms float up on the inhale. Exhale, come down. Go ahead and close your eyes. Just relax. Feel a nice wave of relaxing energy moving downward through your body. One more time, nice deep breath. And bring both hands over your lower abdomen. Go ahead and bring your feet together. And just take a few deep breaths all the way down into your belly. Let everything settle in and relax. When you inhale, let the belly expand, let the breath come down. Exhale all the way out. That one more time. And just feel that peace and tranquility ripple through your whole system.
Welcome to this 20-minute Qigong routine for the evening or anytime you need a little stress clearing and stress relief in your day. All right, let's begin. Take your hands up by your shoulders. We're going to inhale and look up. And then when you exhale, you're going to round your back and tuck your tailbone under. This is called spinal cord breathing. And it helps to transition your nervous system from a stress or busy kind of place into a relaxation response. Brings you from your sympathetic into your parasympathetic nervous system. Again, inhale, look up. Exhale, round the back. Breathe some calm, relaxed, open energy through the spine and your nervous system. Keep your knees slightly bent through this whole exercise. Inhale, the chest opens. Exhale, tuck your tailbone under, round the back. Feel the way the joints in the spine move. They articulate from the front into the back, breathing in flexibility and suppleness into your spine. One more time, inhale, look up. Exhale, round your back. And now turn to one side. Let's turn to this side and inhale, look up, and come to your center and around the back. And turn to the other side. Inhale, look up. Exhale, round the back to the center. And turn and bring the spiraling energy up the spine to the chest. Exhale to the center. And turn, spiraling energy up the spine, opening into the chest. Back to the center on the exhale. Feel the energy rise up and open your lungs and your heart. Use that deep breathing. Let the movement unfold through your body. Good. One more time. Inhale. Back to the center. Exhale. And relax. Very nice. Next one is called water waves. It helps to bring energy out of your head down into your body. It will help you feel centered and balanced. Arms out to your sides. Turn your hips and your waist. And just let your arms float through the air in front of you and behind you. The arms swirl through the air and feel this kind of swirling energy down toward your center. Again, relaxing your mind, relaxing your body. Feel as if your fingers are just gliding through water. Your fingers gliding through water. Bring your awareness to your hands. Let your mind sink into the present moment by feeling what your body's doing. Feel the air move through the fingers and across the arms. Take a deep breath. Just start to get out of the head, into your energy, into the present moment. Deep breathing, hips relaxed, neck and shoulders relaxed, letting the energy swirl around you and through you. Close your eyes and just feel what your body's doing. This will activate a calming and a relaxing energy. Take one more deep breath. And then slow it down. Slow it down. And bring your hands down to your sides. Now take your palms so they're face forward. And we're going to breathe some energy into the hands. And then come through. And this will be a nice stretch for your neck and shoulders. Reach the fingers down towards the floor. Press your shoulders down. And this is our exhale. Inhale, your hips glide back, arms in front of you. And exhale, extend your hands down towards the floor. This is called spreading the feathers. And it'll stretch the lines of tension from your neck area all the way down through the arms. This one's good if you've been working on the computer. It's for tightness in the neck and shoulders or carpal tunnel or any kind of tendonitis in the arms. Let's do it again. Inhale here. Gather energy, exhale, and stretch. One more time. Exhale, stretch. Stand tall. Spread the feathers. Now go ear to the shoulder. And then slowly roll the head to the back of the shoulder. And then forward to the front of the shoulder. And here, when you come to the back of the shoulder, feel how that opens the front of the neck into your jaw. And then roll the head forward, the back of the neck to the cranial base. One more time, to the back and forward. Now go chin to the chest. Cross over to the other side and roll the head back. And roll the head forward. And we use the movement of the head as a way to release tension and tightness out of the neck and shoulders. Here, take a deep breath. Long exhale. Feel the breath helping your body to release tension and tightness. Try that one more time. Slowly roll the head to the back of the shoulders. Keep reaching the fingers towards the floor. And now chin to the chest and relax. Good. So that opened the outer part of the arms. Now we're going to open the inside of the arms. Take the back of the hands, face them forward, and then scoop the energy up behind you and extend out through the fingers. So again, back of the hands are forward. Now we gather energy from behind us, bend the knees here, and then stand tall and stretch. Back of the hands forward, inhale. Exhale, extend, reach down towards the floor. Back of the hands forward, inhale, gather the energy. Exhale, reach towards the floor. Spreading the feathers. Now reach towards the floor and then go ear to the shoulder. Again, this will open the inside part of the arm. Really good for preventing carpal tunnel and opening the neck. Roll the head to the back of the shoulder. Roll the head forward towards the front of the shoulder. Take a deep breath. A long exhale. Now go chin to the chest. Roll over to the other side. Gently roll the head back and forth across the shoulder. Go a deep breath. Use the breath as a way to release tension when you exhale. Feel any tension, tightness release through those muscles. One more time. Chin to the chest. Arms relax down to the sides. And now feel your energy. We release tension and tightness, and now that chi is flowing. Close the eyes. Feel the buzzing, tingling, warmth going down to your fingertips. We turn tension into flowing, healthy energy. All right, now just shake it out. Shake out your wrists and your elbows. Shake your shoulders. Shaking is a fabulous way to clear tension and tightness in the body. We see this done with athletes when they get nervous before an event. You start to shake. Shaking clears nervous tension and tightness. Bounce a little into your heels. And inhale through your nose. Exhale out through the mouth. Bounce into your heels and then relax the back of the neck. Relax your chest. Relax your tailbone. Take a deep breath. And now bring your hands up over your head, palms touch. And then when you exhale, your hands come out and we shake. When you touch the palms, this is the heart meridian, so it clears emotional stress and tension. You connect that point. When you come out to the sides, shake. So here, deep breath. Touch those points. Exhale. Whatever energy you're carrying from your day that you want to let go of, just let it release on this long exhale. If you feel like you've picked up any energy from anybody else that you no longer need, let it go. One more time. Inhale up. Exhale. Hands down to your sides. Close the eyes. Feel your energy. Whole body should be active and your chi buzzing and tingling through you. Now take a deep breath, bring your hands up over your head, palms touch, and again exhale into that shaking. Inhale, touch those heart points. Exhale, release any emotional stress as you shake it off. One more time. Inhale, come up. Exhale, shake it off. And close your eyes. Feel the energy awake, alive, and circulating in your body. You can feel this electricity, this chi moving down the arms to the hands, down the feet, up through the spine to the head. Whole body filled with light and energy. From here, we're going to do a movement called chi massage. This is a calming, clearing, and stress-relieving chi massage. Hands come up, palms touch again. Feel like you're connecting yourself to the energy above you. And then brush the back of the neck and the back of the head right down through the throat center. So inhale, exhale, clear tension and stress right at the base of the skull and the back of the neck to the throat. So come up, inhale. We feel connected to that energy above us. Down the back of the neck to the throat. Now turn the back of the hands so they point towards each other. Touching, fingers pointing towards the throat. Come down through the heart center to the belly and then wrap around to your kidneys and massage your kidneys. So again, you come up, inhale. Clear where we carry stress and tension in the body. Back of the neck, throat center, heart center, down to the belly and now to your kidneys. Kidneys and adrenal glands, you massage them. Then from here, inhale and brush down the back of the legs. So we go down the back of the legs, up the inside of the legs, and center your energy at your belly. Good. This is an antidote to your stressful day. If you've been feeling busy or tense or any kind of anxiety through the day, this little chi massage sequence clears it out. Inhale, coming up, palms touch, brush the back of the head, clear tension out of the neck and the throat center, calm the heart center, and massage the adrenals and the kidneys. Take a deep breath. Exhale down the back of the legs, up the inside of the legs, and circle at the lower abdomen. Let's do that again. Inhale. Palms touch. Clear tension out of the back of the neck. Open the flow through the throat and the heart center. Down to your kidneys. Massage and soothe the kidneys. Part of the stress response is that the adrenal glands get activated. So here you calm them, soothe them, and then send old energy down the legs to the earth. And now we take up fresh energy up the inside of the legs and create that feeling of being centered and balanced. Just make a little circle at the lower abdomen. One more time, inhale. Exhale. Heart center. Take a deep breath. Take it around to your kidneys. Exhale into the kidneys. Inhale, massage the kidneys. Exhale down the back of the legs. Inhale up the inside of the legs. And center at your lower abdomen. Good. Next, bring your hands in front of you. We're going to do an exercise called bear swimming. Extend your arms forward, and then we'll spiral behind ourselves. This one tonifies and strengthens the lungs. Inhale and expand. Exhale forward. Inhale to breathe in, to get inspired. We inhale fully, we can take life in. Inspiration. When we tonify the lungs, we can connect to that feeling of being inspired. So exhale out. Inhale, draw the energy in. Exhale and feel yourself just pushing past your limitations or your blocks. And then inhale, breathe in your inspirations. Exhale, clear old energy. Inhale, feel into your potential. This one tonifies the lungs. Lungs are good for energy and vitality, and emotionally they cultivate inspiration, feeling connected to your purpose. Great, and now we'll switch the direction. Come forward, hands in front of you. Feel the energy come into your palms and pull the energy into the chest. Inhale, expand. Exhale, float the hands out, back of the hands towards each other. And now spiral the hands in, into the heart center. Exhale, back of the hands towards each other. Inhale, spiral in. Exhale out. That first flow connected to the lungs and inspiration. The second one connects to the heart and it cultivates that feeling of being excited or passionate about your life. Open your heart center. Inhale, breathe that energy into the heart center. Exhale, into the flow. Anything that feels heavy in the heart center, when you feel weighed down, just exhale and clear it out. And breathe in excitement and joyfulness, happiness into the heart center. Exhale and inhale. Let it flow through you from the shoulders all the way to the fingertips. Spiral the energy in. Breathe it in. Now relax your hands down to your sides and feel the energy. Again, just check in. Notice how your energy is awakened and enlivened. Stress transformed into vitality. Now with that nice lightness and openness in the heart, inhale and feel your arms float up. Exhale, float the arms down. Inhale, float the arms up. Exhale down. This is called flying. Now that the energy is circulating and light in your body, let it flow through you and create this feeling of levity. Inhale all the way up to the shoulder, standing a little taller. Then exhale, bend the knees. And inhale, float the body up. Exhale down. Anything that's feeling heavy or weighing you down in your life here, just exhale it out. Let it go. Breathe in lightness and relaxation. The legs pulse, so you stand a little taller and sink into it. Feel as if you're flying. What would that feel like? To be very light in your body. Inhale and exhale. Just close the eyes. Feel the air moving through the fingers. Feel the chi circulating and flowing in your body, creating that nice openness in your heart, peacefulness in your energy, and lightness in your whole being. Now take the arms all the way up over the head. Inhale, palms face towards you. Exhale and come down, pulling down the heavens. Inhale, feel nice waves of relaxing energy moving through you from the head all the way down to the feet. Pulling down the heavens. And just feel like you can bring in whatever kind of energy you need for balance and harmony, for calming the mind and recharging the body. This one's a nice one to do at the end of the day. It's good for sleep. In Qigong, we say that you need relaxing energy to sleep. So fill yourself up with relaxing energy so that you sleep well and become well rested during your sleep. Inhale and exhale. We'll do that one more time. Take a deep breath. And we'll bring it to the center. Bring your feet a little closer together. And now just close your eyes. And feel that sense of energy moving through you. The energy will give your mind something to pay attention to. So when you close your eyes and you feel this tingling, buzzing electricity in your body, let your mind pay attention to that and draw your senses inward. And this will calm, relax the mind, let your body recharge. Feel that sense of peaceful vitality flowing through you. Your healing power awakens. Inhale down into the belly. Exhale all the way out. Let your body gently just rock and sway. Go into bamboo in the wind. Just rock and sway a little bit. Relax your neck and your spine. Relax the muscles down through the shoulders and the shoulder blades, all the way down through the hips. Feel rooted down through the legs and the feet, and rock and sway. Take one more deep breath. Very good. Hands down to your sides. Relax. And thanks for joining me. Have a wonderful rest of your day.